Yes, you may be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in this beautiful setting before God to join together Mitchel and Lori in holy matrimony. Marriage is a union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind. It is intended for their mutual joy and for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. But more importantly, it is a means through which a loving and stable environment may be achieved. Through marriage, Mitchel and Lori make a commitment together to face their disappointments, embrace their dreams, realize their hopes, and accept each other's failures. Mitchel and Lori will promise one another to aspire to these ideals throughout their lives together, through mutual understanding, through openness, and through sensitivity to each other. We're here today before God because marriage is one of His most sacred wishes, to witness the joining in marriage of Mitchel and Lori. This occasion marks a celebration of love and a commitment with which this man and this woman begin their new life together. And now through me, the Lord joins you together in one of His holiest bonds. Who gives this woman in marriage to this man? Mitchel, Lori, in the days and years ahead of you, you will experience times of great joy. You will experience times together that you never would have enjoyed on your own. But life is not perfect. There will also be tough times. If you ask any married couple, they will tell you that staying happily married during the good times is relatively easy. It's staying together during the tough times that will test your marriage and test your faith. So in the days and years ahead, as you remember today, it will be remembered as one of the best days of your life. You are deeply in love, the future is bright, and all things are possible. So when times turn difficult, I ask that you think back upon these words of advice. First, let your love be stronger than your anger. Learn the wisdom of compromise, for it is better to bend than it is to break. Look for the best in your spouse rather than the worst. Confide in your partner and ask for help when you need it. Treat your spouse with the same kindnesses you bestow upon your friends. Remember that true friendship is the basis for any lasting relationship. Be sure to say I love you each and every day, and most importantly, trust God and He will lead you to better days. Mitchel and Lori have asked that I now read this special poem, which represents how they feel about each other on this day. How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee to the depth and breadth and height my soul can reach when feeling out of sight. For the ends of being an ideal grace. I love thee to the level of every day's most quiet need by sun and candlelight. I love thee freely as men strive for right. I love thee purely as they turn from praise. I love thee with a passion put to use in my old griefs and with my childhood's faith. I love thee with a love I seem to lose with my lost saints. I love thee with the breath, smiles, tears of all my life. And if God shall choose, I shall love thee better after death. Beautiful. Mitchel, Lori, I remind you that marriage is a precious gift. It is a lifelong dedication to love and a daily challenge to love one another fully, freely, and unconditionally. Mitchel and Lori have chosen rings as the outward symbols of the commitment they make today. From the earliest of times, the ring has been a universal symbol of wedded love. It is an unbroken circle and never-ending circle that symbolizes a commitment to love that is also never-ending. May I have the rings, please? I will now bless these rings and the role they will play in this marriage. May these rings be blessed as a symbol of this affectionate unity. And like these rings, these two lives are now joined together in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, may Mitchel and Lori always return to one another. May they grow in understanding and in compassion. May the home which you establish together be a place of love and happiness. Most importantly, let these rings not serve as locks binding you together, but as keys unlocking the secrets of your heart for each other to know. Mitchel, if you will take this ring, and as you place it on Lori's ring finger, repeat your vows of marriage. I, Mitchel.
I, Mitchel.
Join you, Lori, in marriage.
Join you, Lori, in marriage.
To make you my wife.
To make you my wife.
For the rest of my days.
For the rest of my days.
I will listen to you when you speak.
I will listen to you when you speak.
I will care for you when you are sick.
I will care for you when you are sick.
I will comfort you when you cry.
I will comfort you when you cry.
I will join my laughter with your laughter.
I will join my laughter with your laughter.
I will always trust and respect you.
I will always look for the good in you.
I will delight in the person you are becoming.
I will delight in the person you are becoming.
Whatever lies ahead of us,
good or bad,
I will be your soft place to fall.
I will be your soft place to fall.
Your love will be my only love.
Your love will be my only love.
I will give myself to no other.
So with joy and certainty,
and as a symbol of my promise,
I give you this ring.
And now, Lori, if you will repeat after me your vows of marriage as you place this on Mitchell's ring finger. I, Lori, take you, Mitchel, in marriage. To take you as my husband. For the rest of my days, I will listen when you speak. I will care for you when you are sick. I will comfort you when you cry. I will join my laughter with your laughter. I will always trust and respect you. I will always look for the good in you. I will delight in the person you are becoming. Whatever lies ahead of us, good or bad, I will be your soft place to fall. Your love will be my only love. I will give myself to no other. So with joy and certainty, and as a symbol of my promise, I give you this ring. We will now celebrate the creation of a family through this Unity Sand Ceremony. We are reminded of the significant role that children play in marriage. The vials of sand here represent Mitchel and Lori and each of their children. As each pours the sand into the center container, we will see how the individual colors create a masterpiece of love and mutual respect. And just as the sands are forever intermixed, so are the lives being joined together today. There is also a white container of sand, which represents the will of Christ. And just as the will of Christ will serve as a foundation for this family, it serves as a foundation for this ceremony. I now ask that Mitchel and Lori come back. Mitchel, if you will pour the gray container, and Lori, the purple container. The gray representing Mitchell's personality, which is marked by conservatism, traditionalism, intelligence, and seriousness. Lori's color is purple, representing ambition, wisdom, and imagination. I now call David back to the table. David will pour the blue color, which represents trust, confidence, and loyalty. I now call Chancey. Canty will pour the orange color as it represents her creativity, her attention to detail, her intelligence, and her determination. I now call Zachary, who will pour the green sand, which represents growth, hope, and ambition. And now Manoa will pour the red sand, representing his strength, his energy, his courage, and his determination. Now, Annalisa, you'll pour the yellow sand, representing joy, happiness, liveliness, and energy. And finally, Lila Beth will pour the pink sand, representing her loving and tenderness, her artistic qualities, and her compassion. And I now ask Mitchell and Lori to come back and continue pouring their sands together, protecting each of the colors that they will protect the children in this family. And to finish things off, the will of Christ covering the entire family with his love and protection. Now children, this is going to be displayed somewhere in your home. And if ever in the future you're having a bad day, things haven't gone right at school, you're feeling sad, I want you to go into that room and I want you to look at this container. And I want you to remember how much you are loved by God, how much you're loved by Mitchell and Lori, and your importance in the family. So this is a reminder of this day, and it's always going to be there for you. Be sure to use it, okay? Will you promise? All right. Join hands. Mitchell and Lori have consented together in marriage before God and before this family of friends. They have pledged their faith and declared their unity by the giving and receiving of rings. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. Mitchell and Lori, you have pronounced yourselves as husband and wife, but remember to always be each other's best friend. And so, by the power vested in me by the state of Georgia and Almighty God, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. May your days be good and long upon the earth. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe you all have bubbles on your chairs. We have bubbles?
Everyone, pass the bubbles out.
No? Oh, there they are. We're going to pass out bubbles. If you would help us by opening the bubbles as we celebrate this couple. Would blow the bubbles and help me welcome for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Mitchell Davis.
I've been a walking heartache, I've made a mess of me. Person that I've been lately ain't who I want to be, but you stay here right beside me, watch out.